As long as we live. But yet, we know that he's better off now than he's ever been. Because if anyone here knows Danny, they know that Danny loved the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and accepted him as Lord and Savior. And now he's with him. He's with him, celebrating without any pain, any sorrow. The only sorrow is in our hearts that we're going to miss him. But I pray that each one of us celebrate and understand where he is. In the name of Jesus, we do pray. Amen.
At this time, Gary Priest will come and sing.
Only
time, Mr. Al will come and he'll lead us in a song.
451, tell it to Jesus.
Let me share a few passages of scripture with you from the Word of God. First, coming out of 2 Corinthians chapter 1, and then in verse 3 through 7, here, the Word of God does indeed relate to us concerning different things concerning comfort, grace, and also of mercy. Praise be to God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all of our troubles, so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort that we ourselves have also received from God. For just as the sufferings of Christ overflows into our lives, so also through Christ our comfort overflows. And if we are distressed, it is for your comfort and salvation. If we are comforted, it is for your comfort, which produces patience, endurance, and the same when we suffer as well. And then concerning as well what takes place after death, and what the Word of God again says from 1 Corinthians chapter 15 in verses 50 and following, here we have the assurance from the Word of God. I declare to you, brothers, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable things, but the imperishable. Listen, I tell you a mystery. We will not all sleep, but we will all be changed. will be changed in the flash and the twinkling of an eye, and at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, the dead will rise imperishable, and we will be changed. For the perishable must clothe itself with imperishable, and the mortal with immortality. When the perishable has been clothed with imperishable, and the mortal with immortality, then the saying that is written will come true. Death has been swallowed up in victory. So where, O death, is your victory? And where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But, thanks be to God, he gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. This is the word of God and what it says concerning those issues. Before people come in and speak, let me share with you a song where even during this time we need to understand that it is well with our soul if we indeed know Jesus Christ as our Lord and our Savior. He brings comfort, grace, and mercy. Concerning Danny Hall, they can so do so now. I think the sewage and then come up here, and she's going to say a few things.
For those of you that do not know me, I'm Danny's Aunt Sue, and this is his Uncle Felix. Danny Boy was special in many ways to many different people. Everyone that he met and was acquainted with, he left a memory. And it was always a great memory. Sometime it might have been a mischievous memory, because Danny could be a little mischievous. Danny was a very unique person. And in my heart, I know he was sent by God to give all of us love, pleasure, and many beautiful memories, from his dancing at Christmas Eve with my daughter, from playing Santa Claus on Christmas Eve. The joy that he received out of that was just astronomical. It was heart-rending. His love for family was deep, sincere, and heartwarming. When someone was ill, whether it be a family member, a church member, or someone that he knew from Stark when they were ill, he would tell Virginia, he'd go to his mother and tell her, "Mom, we need to go to the table and we need to pray for these people." And they sat at that table many, many, many times, praying for this congregation, for many people that were ill. He loved this church. Pastor Frank, all the members here. And when he came to church every time, he brought his Bible with him. He was with the Lord. And I remember when I was sitting with him one night, it was during the pandemic, and it was time for the service to come on for Pastor Frank. And Linda reminded him that it was time for the service. So I sat with him at the table, and Linda put the service on, and we listened to Pastor Frank and the singing and his homily. And Danny was intent. He did not take his eyes off of the screen. He did not look around. He was intent to keeping up with Pastor Frank, with the word that was being said. He was a deep thinker. There were some funny things that I have to share about Danny. He had a memory that I have never known before from anyone. He remembered something that my mother did over 30 years ago. When my mother, we were Cajuns, and when my mother, anyone came around and they had a cold, my mother had to fix a little hot tidy for them. Lemon, water, lemon juice, and maybe there was a little smidgen of a little something else in it. That was my mother. So quite recently, Danny took a cold. He went to Linda, and he told Linda, I'm taking a cold, and I need you, this was his words, the way he was a little bossy sometimes, I need you to fix me a hot toddy, like Mama Bouquet used to do. Now this was over 35 years ago. And I thought, when Linda told me this, I just went into tears. I knew his memory, and I mean, he remembered everything I ever said because he told his state workers, he had two state workers, two or three times a week that came in. And he told his state workers everything that I ever said to him. He told them that when I'm at Aunt Sue's and I'm playing music, they have the music on, she always comes up to me, Danny, we have to lower the music now. It's a little bit too loud for me. And he'd go tell the state workers, Aunt Sue always told me I had to lower the music every time I was at her house. So he didn't forget. He didn't forget anything. It was amazing to me. And one time when it was my turn to sit with him and stay with him at night, he talked. And most of the time he talked very low, and Felix told me, he said, now listen, when he talks a lot, and when he gets finished talking, and he says, uh-huh, it means, you say uh-huh, because you're agreeing with him. You may not be knowing what he's saying, but just go along with it. So I finally learned, I learned to do that with him. And it was interesting, but one of the times that I stayed overnight with him, and he was doing so much talking, and he said, he always told Uncle Felix this, am I talking your ears off? And he looked at me that night and he said, am I talking your ears off, Aunt Sue? I said, well, Danny, I said, I've been having a little headache all day and I need a little time, I think, to maybe rest my eyes and close my eyes for a few minutes. He said, okay. So he got up from his lounge chair, went to his bedroom, and about 20 minutes later, I could hear him walking down the hall, and he came and stood over the sofa and looked at me, and he asked, has your headache passed you yet? I said, yes, it has, Danny. I said, I rested a little bit and my headache is gone. Well, I think you need to see my doctor, Uncle Felix's doctor, Dr. Eschenik. He believed in Dr. Eschenik. And I said, well, he's a heart specialist, Danny. He can help your headache. Because the last time you came here to sit with me, you had a headache then, and that was 2 months ago when I sat with him. And I'm thinking, oh, I can't use that anymore. I can't use that excuse anymore. But, we loved him. He loved Dr. Felix. Dr. Felix, he had different names for him. Every 3 weeks, Danny had to have a haircut, and he marked it on the calendar. The day that Uncle Felix cut his hair, if Felix wasn't there on that third week, he called him. Sometimes he called him Felix, sometimes Uncle Felix, sometimes Pop. It's whatever our children was calling him at the time. He'd call and he'd say, Felix, what's wrong? I need a haircut. And we weren't laughing at him. It was just so much humor that he brought to us and he gave us. And he thanked Felix every time he cut his hair. He thanked him for it. He had deep, deep feelings and love for people. And it was just amazing to me. It was amazing. And one other memory I just thought of this morning that I jotted down. In Danny's younger day, he went to the Comet skating rink. And he put his skates on, and he held on to the railing, and he went all around in a circle in that skating rink. He was skating, he did it his way. I did it my way, and I said, you did good, Danny. You really did good. And he enjoyed that so much. And he also had to wear, even watching the service that on the internet, he every day of the week, and I think it made him feel special. He had to wear his stark name tag one day when he was watching Pastor Frank and I was sitting with him listening to the service. I said, Danny, after the service was over, I said, it's Sunday, and I said, you're not going to Stark, and you don't. This is the way I do it. So one night, he thought he was going to correct me. When I was fixing his dinner, I put it in front of him. I asked him, I said, Danny, I said, he did not like any of his food touching each other on his plate. And he ate one thing, then he went to the other. He did not mix his food. And I said, gee, Danny, I said, well, you never mix your food? And, no, it's my way. That's the way I do it. So as he was getting ready for bed that night, I was fixing his medicine. I think I did something that wasn't quite the way Linda did it, because he corrected me. And he said, that's not the way Linda does it. I turned around and very nicely I said, this is my way, Danny. This is the way I'm going to do it. I promise you. His life was astronomical. He had the best of the best human earthly life that he could have had. From Virginia, teaching him about the Lord, going to the table and doing all that praying with him. And then Linda taking over her task. It was a great human life that he had. And now he's with the best of the best. He will have the best life. I know his boom box must be up there someplace. There's many, many things I could say about Danny, and I want to, but there's other people that want to speak, I'm sure, and I was just amazed at Danny. I couldn't help his way of thinking. He was so deep. He remembered my children. He remembered my first grandson that went into the military. He talked about that. He said, I'm going to pray for him. He talked about my first grandbaby, great-grandbaby that was born. Her name is Annie, isn't it? And I said, yes, it is. Yes, it is. So he just remembered everything and loved him dearly.
Anyone come on, just come on, walk up here.
Thank y'all. I'm Carol Curo, and I know Danny from Stark, and boy, do I know what you mean about his name tag. And when he lost it, I was the lady he came to have it replaced.
I keep it in my purse.
I just want to share a brief memory that I have of Danny, something that tickles me from when I first started working at Stark 30-something years ago. He was on a work crew at the time. Danny worked. Cleaning, yard work, we did a lot of stuff. And Danny was mischievous, as you just heard, as you probably know as well. He had a lot of little funny sayings. He liked to tease. And he would say something, and the things that he would say are not what I remember. What I remember is what he would say after that. He'd say, "Don't say that, huh? Get you fired for that, huh?" That always tickled me, but Danny was, as I said, one of the first clients I met at Stark, and hearing him say that to me and the things he would say, I thought, oh, I am going to really enjoy being here and working with those like Danny, and I really did, and we all did. We enjoyed Danny so much, and there was much to enjoy about him, and his mom, too. Miss Virginia was such a good mom. They'll both be missed, but I'm glad they're in heaven and looking down on us and praying for us all still. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Talking about Miss Carol, Dean referred to Miss Carol as Carol. And she lives like a block away from where he lives, where we live, and every time we pass her house, there's Carol's house, he said. Carol's not at home. Carol must be at school. And I'm like, yep. So he's, and for his memory, oh my gosh, Deanie had the best memory. He could remember things back when we were little, and they had a shooting at the Howard Johnson's back in the 70s, and we were trying to think, he knew Mr. Max Rodriguez and all them people, they had a bunch of people from Slidell that went over there. And one of the guys that Deanie was real close to that used to come to the junkyard all the time was Mr. Guy, LaBarge or something? What was his name? LeBlanc. Mr. Guy LeBlanc. Well, we were trying to think about it because Mr. Guy had gotten shot. And I was telling somebody the story here a while back, and I said, Deanie, I said, what was that man's name that that got shot at the Howard Johnson's during the sniper incident? And he said, Mr. Guy. I said, what was his last name? And he said, LeBlanc. He remembered everything. I mean, he didn't forget anything. And loved his family, loved his friends, loved his great nieces and nephews. And every time they'd come over there, they would always pay attention to him, and they would always take up time with him. And he loved that. He loved that. I think Xander was probably one of his most recent favorites, because Xander would get up on the chair with him when he was late, when he was sitting in his recliner, and Xander would get up there on top of him and lay down with him and watch TV, lay on his stomach and watch TV. And then Jaden would come over and play basketball with him. And so when he was in the hospital, when he was passing, and I told him, I brought his boom box to the hospital, and I told him, I said, I played music for him for the last 3 days, and I told him, I said, I'm giving your boom box to Jaden. So Jaden has his boom box, and I have a bunch of basketballs that I need to give to Jaden. That was his. And Jaden, I bought him a basketball goal about 3 years ago, and Jaden kind of quit coming over to play. Well, Deanie said, I guess Jaden gave me that basketball goal. And he would. He would go out there, and I'm not lying to y'all. He always threw it underhanded, and he would make 9 out of 10 shots every time. But he loved the Lord, he loved his friends, he loved his family. And when he was in the hospital, he asked me, he said, before he went in the hospital, he asked me, he says, when I die, he says, am I going to go to heaven? And I said, well, Deanie, do you believe in Jesus? And he said, oh, yeah. And I said, you believe in Jesus? You've already asked Jesus to come into your heart when you were baptized. I said, so you're definitely going to heaven. And then when we was in the hospital, before he got hooked up on the machines, he said, You know, it's a good thing you brought me here. You know, and I always wondered what that meant. And after I thought about it, I said, you know, he probably didn't want to pass away at home with me. So he said, it's a good thing you brought me here. And I'm like, you know, I never thought about that until after the fact, you know. But he loved Frank, the song that he sang. Danny loved when he sang that song, because he used to tell me, he said, Frank did a good job. But I want to thank everybody for coming. And please stay after and enjoy in the back. We've got some really good food. And our church members and family and all that brought food and friends, it's amazing the food that we have back there. And I promise you it's all good. Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Anyone else? Anybody else like to speak? Say anything about Danny? You can?
I came to this church here. Started about 20 years ago, and I, you know, met Danny in West Virginia. And when I first met him, you know, like everybody, I always prayed for people who had illnesses or sick. And I used to pray for Danny. I just said, Lord, you know, heal Danny. But you know what? One day he told me Danny's perfect.
Yeah.
And he was. You know, we need to be a lot more like Danny.
Yes.
Danny loved the Lord, and he loved all the time. And I think we can learn a lot from him. He was perfect.
Thank you. Anyone else? We have open time of speaking about Danny, remembering and talking about him. Anybody else would like to say anything else?
I'm going to say a couple words.
Come on.
Well, he loved himself.
A lot of times, people don't think about it. But, you know, how long have I been among the Franco? 25 years, huh?
Oh, 31
years. 31. 31 years. And I joined the church. Can you believe I've been trying to leave beauty that long?
Longer than that.
I don't look too old.
Longer than that.
But Danny and his mom were stable members of the church. And there were only a handful of members at the time. The church had gone through a lot of, I'm going to say, tribulation. Okay? And I've known Frank and his wife. Well, Davidson, she was around 10, huh? So that was, now you, it was all, he was older then when he started dating in high school. And when the opportunity came and they were looking for a pastor, my wife had Frank sent in a resume. He had been called in to be a preacher. And he accepted the call, and he accepted the call, and I said, well, I think we need to be going there too. And from the very first day, I mean, really, Danny and his mom was here, and as him as pastor, me as music director, can tell you exactly the way he said every Sunday.
Yes.
And I don't know how many people know it, but when you're a member of a church, you have a certain seat. You know, you're used to sitting into, and when you come in, they got a visitor that took your place. You know, you got to still smile, you know, go sit there. But Danny always sat there, and I will always remember him sitting there. Danny was always friendly. Every time he was there, we shook hands. To me, he wasn't a big talker, but he enjoyed, and you could tell that he enjoyed being in church. And this is why I said, you know, in our prayers, you know, we're going to miss Danny. We're sorry that he's not here with us. But we can celebrate because we know where he is. There is no ifs, ands, and buts about it. There's no doubt about it. He's gone on to be with the Lord. And I know I will remember him as long as I'm around. And I know that one day, and I hope every one of you one day will see him again. I hope that everyone here knows the Lord and Savior, and that everyone here that knows Danny will see him.
Nobody sat in the seat yet.
Right there.
Anyone else? I don't want to let anybody else, because there's a song here that we want us to play and let you listen to, sung by the king of rock and roll.
My grandmother used to sing this song to him when he was little.
Hopefully, we can see if it works.
Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling from glen to glen, and the dawn. Outside, the summers ago, and all the roses dying. Tis you must go, and I must hide. And white with snow, and I'll be here in sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, I love you so. But if he comes and all the roses die, and I am dead, as dead I will maybe, you'll come and find for
and I shall rest in peace until you go to
with you a few things from the Word of God and concerning this. It's been my privilege, my honor, to have known Danny for over some 31 years. As Mr. Al mentioned, when I first came here back in 1991, a group of ladies were there, and one of those ladies was of course, Miss Virginia Hall, and got to know him real well, and of course got to know Danny. But from the first day that I met Danny, he always had that big smile, always. Always remember that. Even when he sat there, he would smile. He was a simple, friendly young man. Danny loved his family, and he loved his dogs. Go over to the house sometimes and be careful now how you approach Danny, because the dogs would protect Danny, always. And he loved those little dogs, and they loved him as well. He loved to play pool and paint, and as you know, he always listened to music, always. One of his favorite shows was way back when, and all the ways back, was the Lawrence Welk Show. Miss Virginia Hall said, we gotta go home now. Danny's going to watch Lawrence Welk. Go home and in front of the TV and watch Lawrence Welk. He and his mom and sister, they were very, very close, as well as other family members and lots of other families, as well as his one of his favorites, Uncle Felix. Oh, Uncle Felix, go. You see Danny's eyes would just light up when he look at Uncle Felix, or they would talk, or whatever. You know, he and Uncle Felix, is, in the words of Forrest Gump, they were like peas and carrots. they were buddies. He was close to a lot of people at Stark as well. He would often talk about the people at Stark and the people that come, and everybody that would be there for him as well. He loved going to Stark and getting involved with people and doing the many, many activities that would involve this talk. It was a good place, and it was a very common place for Danny, and he felt really welcome and warm there at Stark. You know, so he'd often talk about that. But yet Danny, he loved the Lord. As Al mentioned, he was always here. He would always come to church. He was very, very faithful in coming to church on Sundays, sitting at one place right there. That's where he would sit. He would just smile and shake his hand and say hi, and we would talk a little bit. Understand, Danny was not just a member of Bayou Baptist Church. He was family. It's like the rest of the people who are members of Bayou Baptist Church. They've come to be family. Miss Virginia Hall, sadly, is in a nursing home with dementia, and it's hard for her, it's hard for the family. But knowing Miss Virginia as I do, she was like a mom to me. We would always sit and talk sometimes at the house or here at church. Many things we converse about. But again, Danny wasn't just a member, he was a family. It's hard. This is the hardest part, I think, of being a pastor of a church for so long, that you people that leave, and there have been many that I have reminisced over the years that have gone on to be with the Lord, and it's hard, and Danny's going to be one of them. It's going to be hard and difficult, but I know he's okay. And one day, we'll meet Danny up in heaven, and we'll have a great family reunion that he's having even right now. He's having a great time with family members and friends and others as well. Who knows? Maybe he's playing pool up there. Maybe he is listening to a lot of music on a boombox. No. There's no telling what's going on, but he's having a wonderful time. However, don't expect to find the same Danny when you go to heaven. No, no, no. Not the same Danny. No. He's going to be a different Danny. He's going to be perfect. Sure, he had his things here, but he's going to be perfect in every way. He's going to have a glorified body. He's going to have even a bigger smile on his face. And he is going to be happy, too. Very, very happy. Talking, running, jumping, doing many things. So what will it be like in heaven for the children of God? From the Word of God in Isaiah chapter 11 in verses 6 through 9, here the Word of God relates. The wolf will lie, will live with the lamb, and the leopard will lie down with the goat. The calf and the lion and the yearling will come together. And a little child will lead them. The cow will feed with the bear, and the young will lie down together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. The infant will play near the hole of the cobra, and the young child will put his hand in the viper's nest. And they will neither harm nor destroy on all of my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. You see, here I think in many, many ways, here it's talking about the 1,000-year reign of Christ when he comes. It will be like unto that in heaven, where the reign of Christ is described by the prophet Isaiah. There will be peace and safety. No longer will there be fear among the people and animals as they are now. All will be like in the Garden of Eden, before sin destroyed the relationships between people and between animals. There will be harmony, there will be friendship among all the nations, as well as all the people, and as well as all the animals. There will be no fear of harm or attack. Such a great sense of calmness, peace, happiness, that one has not known for a long, long, long time, even before we were born. And then we'll walk down the streets of heaven. This is a place to where Danny is. But also, according to the Word of God as well, from coming from Revelation chapter 21, it's also a new order of things, one that we're not familiar with, but yet one that we will see and be accustomed to one day when we go to heaven. As it relates in Revelation chapter 21 and verses 1 through 5, then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride, beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, now the dwelling of God is with men, and he will live with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, mourning, crying, or pain, for the old order of things has passed away. He who was seated on the throne said, I am making everything new. And he said, write it down, for these words are trustworthy and true. Everything will be new. Danny will be new. Everyone in heaven will be new. A new heaven, a new earth. One without sin, one without death, pain. A time of joyous celebration, as well as, unheard of, no crime, no killing, and no evil. All will be good. Everything and everybody will be made new. And God will rule, and he will rule with equity and perfection. There will be no bias. None of this is going on. There'll be no favors. Everyone will be treated the same. Just as God treats everyone the same today. There is no difference. God doesn't look at a person and say who you are, what you are, what you are. He looks at the heart. And God only sees the heart and the person that has been renewed by the blood of Jesus Christ. And you are a child of God if you know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. See, we will be a people not only belonging to God, but would be in the very presence of God. No cemeteries up there. No coffins. No cremations. No funeral home. No more departures. No types of suffering whatsoever. It will all be just like at the beginning in the Garden of Eden. You remember when Adam and Eve walked with God in the cool breeze and the coolness, and there they walked with God. It'd be the same way. We'll walk with God. Not only us, but friends, family members, and all who belong to the Lord. Oh, Danny Boy is enjoying a type of home right now that we will see one day. Indeed, Danny is at home. And the reason he's at home in heaven is because, as you've heard, Danny knew the Lord Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior. It wasn't just an intellectual thing. It was a heart thing. His heart was changed by Jesus Christ. He knew Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior. He believed that Jesus Christ died on the cross for his sins and that Danny inherited because of what Jesus Christ did at Calvary. He inherited all because of God's grace and blessings, as it is mentioned also here in Revelation chapter 21. He who overcomes will inherit all of this, and I will be his God, and he will be my son. Danny is a son belonging to the Lord. And also remembering the words in which Jesus told his disciples as well. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You trust in God? Trust also in me. In my Father's house there are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I am going there to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. And of course, you know, Philip said, well, Lord, how do we know? How does it know? And Philip, as well as Thomas, and even Thomas said, Lord, we don't know where you're going. How can we know? And he told Thomas, he said, Thomas, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. And that is the only way to heaven. Contrary to beliefs of all so many people and what they think, there is only one way. And Jesus is the only way. He is the way, the truth, and the life. And in him is salvation. Danny Boy overcame because he put his trust in Jesus. I think he had that smile on his face because he knew Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior. And he knew. I hope today that you have done, if not, that you too can come to know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior and be a child of God and inherit such a thing that awaits every truly born-again believer. Wonderful benefits and the grace and the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ, and a home forever without pain, suffering, death, sorrow, or even any separation or departure. No longer will we be saying goodbyes, but it will be hello forever and ever, embracing one another. That's where Danny is. And Danny boy, today he walks the streets of gold. He begins a new life, a perfect life, a life to where it is with the Lord and all the children of God. And again, I truly hope that you too know the Lord Jesus Christ, and you look forward to, as I look forward to one day, walking the streets of gold, and there being not only with Danny boy, with so many others that I know, and probably so many others that you have known, that have gone on to be with the Lord. And I can mention many that have been here at Bayou Baptist Church over the 31 years that I've been here. So many that I have think about, and I know about, and I think often saying one day, we'll meet together again one day. And I hope that you too will do that. Mr. Al will come at this time, and he'll lead us in our closing hymn, hymn number 448, Just a Closer Walk with Thee. Let's stand and sing 448. Each and every one, to be with them, to help them, and to watch over all who are here and the many friends and family. All this we ask in the name of Jesus. This concludes our service for today. We do have food in the back for everybody. We invite everybody to come. But if you want, you can spend some time here right now and gather with the family as well. We thank you for coming.
I have some time to do.